Mr. President, and distinguished guests from the United States and foreign countries, to the dedication of the United States Pavilion in the 1982 World Fair. I really would be remiss if I didn't say thank you to the I'd first like to introduce some special guests. On my right, Congressman James Quillen. Would you please stand? Where is he? Congressman, this is John Duncan, the Commissioner General of the 1982 World's Fair, Deutsch Kohl. Secretary of Agriculture, John Block. And our great governor and his wife, a very special guest, Omar Baldonado. Omar is here really for a very enthusiasm we have to say welcome to President Mrs. Reagan to the US Pavilion today. Mr. President Omar, beginning late last year, and he has purchased a $120 structure, and as I mentioned earlier, every citizen in this country that helped finance it is going to be proud of it for many, many years to come. It would not be what it is. It's a real pleasure to introduce you, the Honorable Malcolm Baldrige, Secretary of Commerce.
It's been done here, and the people who have planned, worked, and will care for this pavilion over the next 6 months. And it's most fitting that to mark this historic occasion for the city of Knoxville, the state of Tennessee, President and Mrs. Reagan are here. How can you, if you put yourself in my place, how can you adequately introduce a man whom you admire and respect as much as I do the President? I think it makes you... Thank you.
Isn't it wonderful to see young people still under go as far as their talent and effort will take them? This beautiful pavilion is proof that other generations of Americans believed in dreams. It's wonderful book Omar may be familiar with. There's a character in that book who's trying to find a way to extract sunbeam
the day the rockets on their carriages go by and the troops and the bayonets and so forth. They celebrate a government that promises a freedom it systematically denies, that proclaims justice while practicing tyranny, and that uses what it calls law as little more than a thin. Thanks be to God, we're free, just as we have been. Omar and his generation are free to dream and then turn those dreams into reality. As you walk through these exhibits today, just imagine. I wish all of you a good time and hope that as you stroll around these grounds, you're as grateful and proud to be an American as I am, and Nancy is. God bless you and thank you all again. Very, very proud of them.